YouTube, this is Rock at Omaha Air Tactical, and today we're looking at another classic Army gun, very iconic gun. Some of you may recognize as either the SR25, also known as the XM110, when it's set up as its whole system with the scope, bipod, and sound suppressor. Anyways, this particular model is a classic Army CA25, basically. As I was saying, the SR25, and then the full A2 stock, standard A2 pistol grip. You're gonna have a giant, 300, round high cap here, and this will be obviously a little bit larger than your normal M4 because it's supposed to take accommodate 7.62 round instead of a 5.56, and that's why it's a larger magazine size. So. Something else to note about these guys is on the internal wise is these do use the elongated gearbox. It's a 2.5. So your sector gear as well as your piston are going to be a little bit different than what you'd find in a normal V2, as well as your air nozzles will be a little bit longer as well. But you got full rail all the way up here. This is all Armalite. They make a URX version where you have a monolithic rail going all the way across the top. Right now we're just working with the CA25. But right now we got the little Mark III, Leopold Mark III on top here, right? And definitely adds some appeal to the gun, to say the least. But then in case that for some reason a crazy accident happens, you got your flip up irons right here. And one of the neatest features is, which is actually included with the gun, is this detachable suppressor, which is a trade by Armalite. CA's had the trades for Armalite for quite a while, but basically it covers up just the small bowl barrel, and then that way, I mean, you want to conceal your launch tip very, very easily when you're out in the field, so you're not a giant target out there. If you do, just put this guy on, line it up with the gas block, push down, and you got your suppressor. Use a standard M4 hop-up. You'll see on that side, and other than that, yes, this one is will absolutely fire in full auto. It's not set up as a DMR. I don't know what this shoots right out of the box. We will find out momentarily, and from there we will determine if it is somewhat DMR worthy. But this is a excellent platform to start from if you're building a DMR. Meet you guys at the chrono. Alright guys, very, very awesome numbers at the chrono, shooting right around 425, 430, which are the first shots out of the gun. So once that bucking breaks in a little bit more, maybe if you threw a tight bore in here, maybe 509, 603, something like that, you'd be sitting right around 440, 450, which here in Nebraska those are our DMR limits. Only thing you have to do is to make this guy a DMR, then would be to either get a different selector switch on here so you cannot go to full auto, or you can go inside a new selector plate and modify that so it does not get engaged in full auto. But I actually have not this exact model. I have the CA25 URX. It's got a monolithic rail on. It's a little bit different. That's what I use. This is literally my DMR platform that I use. I'm able to consistently hit people at 240, 250 feet with it. They are the perfect starting platform. If you're familiar with the M4 variant and you don't want to move to an M14 or something like that, then the SR25 is right up your alley. This is Rock, signing off, OAT. Thanks for checking it out.